Today we'll talk about ELT and what is the difference between ETL and ELT. Agenda for today is to give you basic definition about ELT, after that real world example to get better understanding, and then again with real world example and some technical terminology to explain you about the difference between ELT and ETL. If you are not really sure about ETL and want to hear more about it, I already had a video in my YouTube channel about it. I will put a reference in the end of this video. Now just sit and enjoy of your watching about this video, and in the end you will find a reference for ETL if you wish to be more familiar about this process too. If you like this video, if you want to be part of our community, don't wait, click on the subscriber button and not forget to click on bell button too. Smash it. Now actually let's start with the actual part and first the definition about ELT. What is it behind of this terminology? It's really similar to ETL, the same word, just the order it's little different. First we have extract, after then we have a load a data in our data warehouse or data lake, and then when we have the whole data in one environment, easily we could transform it. Extract, load, transform. That is the ELT. From the real world, let's use the pizza example, but in this video the pizza example will be a little more different than the ETL. Here if we want to eat a pizza, then what we could do, we don't want to waste a time to visit different shops or to go across the whole shelves in the supermarket to get the whole products that we need to prepare a pizza, but we really want to eat the pizza and we are not so, how to say, don't want to waste that time, then we just could buy a pizza that it's already ready to be eaten, and we just could bake it. There are a lot of pizzas that we could just buy and only we need to bake it. And this kind of pizza, what are they in our data example? Let's say that we already have a data in a freezer in our supermarket. They already get the whole products that are needed to be prepared pizza. They cut it, put in them place and so on. And we just need to transform after that this pizza. But the whole data, it's already there. It's already in a freezer. That is the ELT. They get data, load it, and when the customers want, they could after that transform it and bake it, and we'll be ready for analytics part. If you want to cut it on different pieces or just could eat it as it is, and so on and so on. But data, first it's get it, put it in a freezer, and we already have it for transformation part, because when we buy this kind of pizza, if we want, we could put extra salami, mozzarella to make it little more different and little more delicious than it is at the moment, and we then could bake it. And that's it. What is ELT? I hope this already helped you to figure out that it's the difference between ETL and ELT in the picture. As you could see here, we have extract part in ELT, load it in the place that we want to store this data, and then we easily could transform it. But the transform part, it's here after the load part. About the ETL, first we get the data, transform it, and then we could load it when we wish. If we go back in the pizza example, in first place I already mentioned example for you. In the second, we'll remind you about the ETL example from the ETL video. We get the whole products, cut it, which means we transform the data. Our products here in ETL process are our data from different sources. We modified it and prepare it in the way that looks like a pizza. These products, they are already pizza, and then we could put and bake it and will be loaded and ready for analysis part and data warehouse part. In this picture are some more technical definitions and terminology and little more comparison between ETL and ELT about the purposes. As I already mentioned, in one process we get the data, extracted it, transform it in a good way as we wish, and load it in a data warehouse. In ELT we get the data, load it usually in data lake, and then we could transform this data. Expense, which is more expense, usually when we do ETL we use extra service data. First it put it in separate server and we use tool or service to do the transform part, and when we are ready and these tools are working in them servers, we could make the transformation and put in another server where it's data warehouse already created. About the ELT, it's really easy because we just get the data, put in a place that we want to have our data, and in the same place we transform it, which means less servers. And yeah, and it's the cost, it's cut in EOT part, which means that ETL it's more expensive. Maturity, ETL process it's really old and the people used for a while. EOT, how to say, it's not new process, but in the meantime it's a process that the people till now not use so frequently, and for this reason we cannot find a lot of resources if we are struggled and need some support. About the ETL, there are a lot of forums and places that we could find the information. For the privacy, data that we load in ETL usually it's already transformed, it's aggregate and so on. For this reason we don't need to secure on so big level as EOT, because the EOT data it's a raw data, it's exactly the same from our sources, we just put in one place to be easily processed and transformed. But we have the raw data, and when we have the raw data we need to protect in really 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 good way. About the maintenance, as I already mentioned in the previous points, definitely ELT it's easier to be maintenance than ETL. I hope you like this video. If I'm right, don't wait, click on the like button too, and we'll see you in the next video. Thank you for the watching.